Hello everyone, welcome back to another Blender tutorial. Today I'm going to be showing you how to work with some fluid simulations and just make a pretty cool image from that. So let's get started. First thing, bring this tab out like we usually do. Okay, so this cube is going to be the fluid. So if you press 1 on the numpad, then 5, then you'll go into the front view. And let's scale this up just a little bit. So you press S, then X, and you can scale it up to about there. Maybe scale it along the Z by pressing S, Z, and just bring it down just a little bit. Then go into the side view by pressing 3 on the number pad, and scale it up on the Y by pressing S, then Y, and bring it right about there. That looks pretty good. And also you can move the window if you hold your middle mouse button, then move the mouse, you can move it like that. Okay, next thing we're going to do is add a domain. So press Shift D while the cube is selected, and then scale it up just a little bit. Then press 1, and then Z to go into wireframe view, and then scale it up along the Z axis by pressing S, Z, and scale it up right about there. Then if you grab this arrow and drag it up, it goes like that. And let's go a little bit on the Y a little bit more, so press S, Y, and bring it out. Maybe just scale the whole thing up just a tad. Okay, so now, this is going to be our domain. So come over here to the Physics tab, click Fluid. Change the type to Domain, right there. Then right-click on the other cube inside, then click Fluid, Type, let's go with just regular fluid, just like that. Now, one more thing. Actually, we have to do a few more things. Press 1 on the number pad, then Shift A, Mesh, UV Sphere. Click that. Then bring it down by pressing G, Z, and bring it down right about there. Scale it up. That looks pretty good. Actually, I kind of want this to be scaled just a little bit more. So press S, Y, and scale. Right about there. That looks good. Then press 1 again. And maybe bring the cube down to right about there. Scale it up. I'm just critiquing it. Yeah, that's fine right there. Okay. So bring this down a little bit more. G, Z, and then bring it down. Then click I, Location, Rotation. Then we have to change the frame number to 30. No, not 303, nope, just 30. Then press RR, and you can rotate it however you want. I'm just going to randomly do stuff, whatever. Then GZ, bring it up through it, and then press I, Location, Rotation. So now if we skip back to the frame number 1, then hit the play button, it should go up like that. Pretty cool. Maybe that's a little too big. Scale down. Alright, that is good. Then click the fluid for this guy. Set the type to obstacle. So once we bake it, this thing is going to shoot through this cube down here and then make it like explode and stuff, and it's going to look pretty cool. But first we have to do some settings for the fluid. So right click on this and let's set the final to, let's go with 150. And you can set the preview to 100. And I'm going to set a cache folder, because I already have one. Let's go with, where is it at? Baking caches. I'm going to do it tutorial 3. There we go. Let's see here. Is there anything else we need to do? Subdivisions, maybe bring that up just 1. Fluid particles. All right, right-click on this guy to select him, and also right-click on this to select it. I don't know if I said that or not. And let's change the slip, bring it down almost to 0, let's go with like a 0.05, that looks pretty good. I think we are ready to bake. Actually, change this to 2, I almost forgot to do that. And also the frame number, the end frame, let's go with 45, because we don't want the bake to go through every single one of these frames, just this. Alright, so now let's save it by pressing Ctrl S. I'm going to save it to my desktop, and I'm going to call it, what am I going to call it? Tutorial. fluid. There we go. And save it. So once you've saved it and you've done everything, hit bake. Okay, this might take a little bit of time depending on how fast your computer is, so I'm just going to pause the render, or not the video, I'm going to pause the video and come back with you once it's done. Okay, it is finished. The baking is done. Let's play it and see what it looks like. Oh. That's pretty cool. That is pretty cool. We're not going to need this cube right here, so if you press Z to go into wireframe, you can delete this guy. You don't need him anymore. So, yeah. I kind of like it. So press 1 on the number pad, and you can zoom in. Let's go, like, right here. Then press Control-Alt-0 to snap the camera to wherever you were looking. Then right-click on the camera to select it. G, middle mouse button, and you can bring them back. Bring it to the side. Let's go right here, maybe. Just, and you can press G to move the camera like this. So I think this is a nice spot. So, yeah, I like it. So right-click on the fluid to select it, then click Smooth. Then right-click on the cylinder, or not the cylinder, the UV sphere, and then click Smooth. And then right-click on the fluid to select again, and let's add a subdivision surface so it's just a little bit more smooth. So click Add Modifier, and you have to click the wrench. Add Modifier, Subdivision Surface. Then change that to 2, and it might be a little bit laggy, so I'm going to just turn that off right now. But in the render, it will show up like pretty nice. So let's do some lighting and some stuff. So go into side view by pressing 3, then press Shift A, Mesh, Plane, and scale that plane up really big by pressing S, then G, Z, and bring it down to right about there. Then if you zoom out with the scroll wheel, actually I think this is too big, so scale it down. Zoom in, then go into edit mode by pressing Tab, then Z, then A to deselect everything, then press B and draw a box around these back ones. Then extrude it up by pressing E. There we go. Let's go into the camera to see if we can see it. Yep, we can see it, just like that. And then press Control 3, and that will add a subdivision. That's the shortcut, Control 3, or Control 2, or whatever. Then let's bring this up to 6, same thing for this guy. Then click the Smooth button. There we go. So let's do some materials now. So click the Material button, click the New button, and now let's change this to Cycles Render. So come up here and click Cycles. Click Use Nodes, and let's set this to Mix Shader, and we're going to do Diffuse and Diffuse and Glossy. There we go. And then Glossy. And bring the factor down to like a 0.2, somewhere in there. Okay, let's do the material for the water. So right-click on the water, click Use Nodes, and let's set it to a glass shader. And you might have to scroll up a little bit. Glass shader, right there. Then set the IOR to 1.33. There we go. And that, it just makes it like more blurry, sort of what water would look like. Then you can set the color to whatever you want. I'm going to go with a slight bluish color, just a slight bluish, not a lot, just a little bit. And then let's do the material for the UV sphere. So right click on it, click the new button, and let's go with a glossy shader. Now for the color, what should I use? I think I'm going to go with a green lime aqua color. Actually, no, I want to do a blue color. So click on this, set it to a nice light blue somewhere in there. Let's check the preview to see how it looks like. Yeah, I like it. Let's keep it. So one more thing before we render, we have to set up a little bit of lighting. So press 3 on the number pad and zoom in and right click on this guy to select him. It's the lamp. Then drag them over here, click Use Nodes, and actually I'm going to use a sun lamp. So click the sun, then rotate it by pressing R, and then drag them way back over here. And the strength is way too high, so let's just go with like a 0.7. Then the color, let's go with the light blue, just a little bit of the light blue. All right, now press 0 to go back. Actually, it's off to the side. So press 7, then rotate them till it's right in the center, just like that. Then press 0. There we go. Okay, let's do a render. So press Control S, and then save, and click render. And this should go pretty fast, hopefully. Oh, I might have to cut, so I think I'll be right back. Okay, it is done, and it looks okay. It's not the best. So let's go over here and click the 3D view, then click the, let's change the color of the fluid just a little bit. So click on the material button, and let's just change it to a white color. I think it's like too much of a bluish color. And also, it's pretty dark, so click the world button and bring it up to like almost, let's go with like a 0.9 for that. I think that'll be pretty good. Also, a thing that I did is I changed this to 3, or to 2 instead of 3 because it was at 3, and that does slow down the render. So I think I'm going to change it to 3 now since we're going to do a final render. Actually, let's do one more quick render to see how this looks, then we'll do a final render. So let's save it one more time by pressing Control S and click render. And I'll be right back again. Okay, it is done. And it looks pretty good. It's really noisy right now. If you can see over here, it's just really, really noisy. We'll fix that once we do a high res render. But first, let's do a little bit more with the world background. I want to change it to a little bit of a darker color because I think it's just a tad too bright. All right, let's do a high-res render. So come down here to the render panel, click the sampling, and change this to 300. Okay, and change the clamp to 3, and just gives it a little bit better results. Like there's no fireflies or anything like that. You can turn off reflective and refraction, whatever that word is. I'm not going to try to pronounce it. And once you've done that, you can click render, actually save it, then click render. Alright, this is going to take a really long time, so I'm going to cut one more time, and we'll see what it looks like. Okay, the render is finished, and that took like 26 seconds. But it looks really cool. I really like this flow right here, and all just how this just flies up through it, and this looks really nice. So, I like it. So, let's save it. I've said so many times today. So. Okay. Let's save it by pressing F3 while you're hovering over the image. And I'm just going to save it to my desktop, and I'm going to call it Water Tutorial. And save. So, that concludes this tutorial, and I just said so again. Thank you for watching. If you learned something new, or if you made something cool with this, leave it in the comments, and I'll check them out and stuff. So, yeah. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.